Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to locate fractions on a number line. I've got four number lines here and I'm going to show you how to locate these four fractions on these four number lines. The rest two, you have to do it on your own. Okay, the first question is, what is a fraction? A fraction is a part out of whole. A part out of whole. The top part of your fraction is called the numerator. The bottom part of your fraction is called the denominator. Remember this. Numerator, the top part of your fraction, and denominator is the bottom part of a fraction. Okay, when I said a part out of whole, that means my denominator or the bottom part of your number, of your fraction, is the whole. That means it's telling me that my one whole has been divided into seven equal parts. So the first step is look at the denominator. How many equal parts the whole has been divided into? Seven. So let's divide my whole, which is here 0 to 1, into seven equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Let's see. I got one part here, two parts, three parts, four parts, five parts, six parts, and seven parts. Even though they don't look equal, but they have to be equal. So when you are trying to locate fractions on a number line, do your best to divide a whole into equal parts. And I did my best. Okay, so since I'm done with dividing my whole into seven equal parts, my next step is to look at the numerator. My numerator says 3. So we need to locate 3 parts out of these seven equal parts. So as I said, this is my 0 to 1, one part out of 7 equal part. This is my 2 parts out of 7 equal parts. And this is my 3 parts out of 7 equal parts. So this mark is my 3 parts out of 7 equal parts. This mark is my 4 out of 7 equal parts. This mark is my 5 out of 7 equal parts. This is my 6 out of 7 equal parts. And this is my 7 out of 7 equal parts. In another word, you can say it's one whole. Okay, since we are done with locating 3 out of 7, we move on to number 2. Number 2 says 2 out of 5. So we need to locate 2 parts out of 5 equal parts. So look at the denominator. This tells you how many equal parts the whole should be divided into. 5. Let's divide my whole into 5 equal parts. So I've got 0 to 1, one whole. Let's divide it into 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is my 5th part. Let's see. Let's see if I got my 5 parts. 1 part, 2 parts, 3 equal parts, 4 equal parts, and 5 equal parts. So I divided my one whole into 5 equal parts. Even though they don't look equal, you do your best to divide them into, to divide the whole into 5 equal parts. Okay, now since I'm done with dividing my whole into 5 equal parts, I look into my numerator. It says locate the second part out of 5 equal parts, 2. So this is my one part out of 5 equal parts, because my whole has been divided into 5 equal parts in this case. This is my 2 parts out of 5 equal parts. This is my 3 parts out of 5 equal parts. This is my 4 parts out of 5 equal parts. And this is my 5th part out of 5 equal parts, or in another word you can say it's one whole. Now as you can see, my 2 out of 5 is right here. One part and 2 parts. Now move on to number 3. 3 says we need to locate 4 parts out of 10 equal parts. So this is my one whole, 0 to 1. We need to divide. So the first step is look at the denominator. How many equal parts do we need to divide the whole into? Right, 10. So let's divide my whole into 10 equal parts. This is how I divide it. I divide the line into half and then I get 5 equal parts on this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And my other 5 on this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's check whether we divided the whole into 10 equal parts or not. 1 part, 2 parts, 3 parts, 4, 5 parts, 6 parts, 7 parts, 8 parts, 9 parts, and 10 parts. So we divided the whole into 10 equal parts. Now look at the numerator. It says 4. So you're locating 4. Let's locate 4. Starting from 0, this is my 1 part. Out of how many equal parts? Right, 10 equal parts, because this whole has been divided into 10 equal parts. 10. This part, this mark is my 2 parts out of 10 equal parts. This mark is my 3 parts out of 10 equal parts. This mark is my 4 out of 10 equal parts. This is my 5th part or 5 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts out of 10 equal parts. This is my 6 parts out of 10 equal parts. 7 parts out of 10 equal parts. 8 parts out of 10 equal parts. 9 part out of 10 equal parts. And 10 parts out of 10 equal parts. In another word, you can say it's one whole. Now we can easily see my 4 out of 10 equal part is right here. Now let's move on to the last problem that we are solving today. That's 1/3. So look at the denominator. It tells me how many equal parts the whole has been divided into. And here it says 3. So I need to divide my one whole, 0 to 1, into 3 equal parts. 1, 2, and 3. They don't look equal, but I tried my best. Okay, so now that I'm done with dividing my 3 equal parts, the whole into 3 equal parts, I look at my numerator. My numerator says locate one part only. So from 0 to here is my 1 part. Out of how many equal parts? 1, 2, 3, which is my whole. So that's my 1 part out of 3 equal parts. So we already located 1 part out of 3 equal parts. This mark is my 2 parts, 1 part, 2 parts. 2 parts out of whole, 1, 2, 3. The whole has been divided into 3 equal parts. And this is my 3 parts out of whole. And the whole has been divided into 3 equal parts. In another way, you can say it's one whole. Okay? So now I want you to practice to do number 5 and 6 on your own. Try doing them. Look at the new denominator. Draw a number line starting from 0 to 1. Divide this whole into 5 equal parts. Once you are done, you look at the numerator and see where you locate where your number 3 is, okay, where your third part is. Same thing with number 6. Look at the denominator, draw your one whole, divide your one whole into 6 equal parts. Do your best. It may not look equal, but do your best. Once you divide the whole into 6 equal parts, look at the numerator and locate where your second equal part is. Okay? Thank you for listening. See you in the next video.